Hey, Carlos from MikroTik Sales here. Last summer, my colleague Yannis revealed the amazing RB5009, and he also mentioned some additional models coming along in the future. Well, the future is now, and it's looking good. So what's new? This version of RB5009 has all the bells and whistles of the base model, obviously. Gigabit Ethernet, 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet, a 10 Gigabit SFP plus cage. It's fast, it's powerful, it's durable, and, no other way to say this, it looks so cool. But there are some impressive additional features, like PoE-out on all 8 Ethernet ports. But wait, there's more. There's also PoE-in on all 8 Ethernet ports. It took us some time to combine both features in a safe, meaningful way. But we've done it. PoE-out and PoE-in on all ports, without breaking the bank. Sounds too good to be true? I know, but that's just how we roll. So let's dive right in. Let's start with the power options. Double redundancy is great, but this board takes the concept to the next level, more than once. It has 10 possible ways of powering, 8 Ethernet ports with a PoE in, a DC jack, and a 2-pin connector on the side. All these options support a wide voltage range, 24 to 57 volts. There are some important aspects to remember, like the single voltage PoE-out feature. These ports support either 802.3 ATAF or low voltage PoE-out. You can't really mix the voltages, you have to choose. It is determined by the highest voltage on the DC jack or 2-pin connector. So if you're using the PoE ports to power a variety of devices, make sure to check the numbers. And yes, you need to use the DC jack or 2-pin terminal if you want to use the PoE-out feature properly. Each PoE-out port can supply up to 25 watts of power. All the ports combined are limited to 130 watts, which should be enough for most setups. You will be able to specify maximum available power from your power sources in this menu. When it comes to the PoE-out features, RB5009 can trade blows with our legendary CRS354 and the CRS328. As you can see, there's a lot of information at your disposal. But enough with the theory. What exactly happens if all hell breaks loose and something happens with your power sources? So you have the DC jack, the 2-pin connector and PoE-in on, let's say, Ethernet 3. The router itself gets powered from the PoE-in. If there's a problem, RB5009 will fall back to the 2-pin connector, and if that fails, the DC jack. PoE-out devices will take power from the 2-pin connector, if that fails, the DC jack. The board will always reserve 20 watts to power itself. If there is not enough power for all PoE-out ports, it will start disabling the ones with the lowest priority. I think this router can be a great addition to any ISP setups that are taking advantage of our GPON products. But the possibilities are endless, really. This tiny form factor shines anywhere from confined research facilities and offices to huge corporate server rooms. And don't forget that you can mount 4 of these routers in a single 1U rack mount space. With so many powering options and a durable metallic case, the new 5009 redefines reliability. Contact your MikroTik distributor for more information.